Okay, so next talk is by Sebastian Valla, Malt Malloc Tracker about memory profiling.
Yes, hi everybody. So I will present you Malt, so the Malloc Tracker, which is a profiling tool, a memory profiling tool for mostly C, C++, Fortran application, also other stuff if you want, if you are based on these languages. This has been developed at the Exascale Computing Research Lab, which is laboratory in the University of Versailles, mostly financed by CEA, Intel, and some other stuff in Europe to work on supercomputing research field. So memory is something we tend to forget today because we have a lot of memory in our laptop or workstation, not today. But in supercomputing things, we know that today we have really big issues with this kind of thing. So for example, this is a really huge application here with 1 million lines of C++ code. Running on 16 processor servers, so a big thing, not the thing you have on your laptop. But you can see quickly, during my PhD, I was seeing this thing on this application. Just changing the memory allocator on top of this application can change the performance from a factor roughly 4 between the different allocators we are using on this machine. So the performance today about the memory, this is what we call the memory wall, and we are in today with the CPU we have. So understanding the behavior of your application is a thing to understand today. So this is a little bit the goal of this tool. So mostly I was saying during my postdoc at this laboratory, because I was developing a memory allocator during my PhD, and then I was saying myself, we have good profiling tool for timings, meaning the performance. So for example, Valgrind, VTune, this one is not open source, but for memory profiling, in the open source community, we have mostly nothing. I mean, there is some commercial tools, mostly on Windows, not too much on Linux. And for our things, we don't have too much things in the open source field for likely operating system. And so memory can be an issue for two things. First, the availability of the resource itself. If I consume too much memory, how I can reduce the consumption of my application. This is not too much an issue on your laptop today because when you have 16 gigabytes of memory, you rarely use it. But on servers, on supercomputing things, this is something which happens quite quickly. And the performance, which clearly today is again an issue because we have more memory to manage and it's putting more pressure on the operating system under hood. So three questions we want to ask with this kind of tool. How I can reduce the memory footprint of my application? How I can improve the overhead of the memory management of my thing? And maybe how I can improve the memory usage, I mean in the term of layout of the memory, which can sometimes also degrade the performance of the application. So there is mostly three points I wanted to task to attack with this tool. I wanted to know where I allocate my memory in my application, which is something we sometimes as a developer forget to know in our own code. The properties of those allocation, so for example, the sizes, the lifetime of the chunk I'm allocating, this kind of thing. And some ways to maybe point quite a little bit easily the thing, what are the bad allocation patterns we can have in our application. So if I have this simple code here, for example, I already can say a lot of things. So for example, there is global variables, so I want to know the memory I'm using here. Maybe it's more than what I was thinking as a developer. You can have some function which makes some indirect allocation. So this function can come from a library and inside make some mallocs, which I might not know as a developer. Here you can have a memory leak. For this, you already have a Valgrind, but as the tool can do it also, it's nice. You can make a really big allocation here, which might be, 10 gigabytes, and you forget it was there. If you're doing C++, this is a mistake I made during my development at CERN. I forget here to put a reference, and in one of my code, I was generating a lot of allocations I was not aware of. So nice thing if we can also point this kind of stuff. And here you can see I'm allocating a segment, making a quick stuff, and then freeing it. And if you do it a lot of time, you can also have a performance penalty because you have a short life allocations. So I wanted with this tool to have the same approach than Valgrind and Kakashgrind, which are really nice for the performance. So I wanted to map all my allocation on the source line and the call stacks, and provide, of course, the metrics I wanted on this thing. So ideally, I started to use Kakashgrind directly as an output manager of my thing. But I was quickly stuck because I cannot make, for example, time charts, because when we speak about memory management, there is also a dynamic aspect of the thing and not only flat numbers. So at some point, I started to make my own graphical interface based on web technology, which is also a nice try because It shows also some interesting things doing that. So if you are interested a little bit for the backend, if you want to develop such a profiler, you can use the LD preload approach. So you build a dynamic library which provides, again, malloc free and all those functions, just like Google App Profiler does. And you put your thing in between the application and the libc, which is implementing really the malloc thing. You intercept all the functions and build your profile, which is generated as a JSON file. So if another tool wants to use the thing, I think it's quite easy, I mean, to take back. So I map the location on the call stack. So every time you make a malloc, I use a backtrace to find which function have been called to make your thing. And then I build and consolidate my metrics and generate the output files. And so in terms of output, this is a little bit what I have in my graphical interface. So you launch the web server and you go in your browser and you get this thing. So just similarly to what you have in KakaGrind, the list of functions on the left with the price you pay, you can select here the metric you have. So there is roughly, I don't know the exact number, but 10 or 12 metrics which are exported in the tool. So lifetime, minimal size, and so many things you can look to try to understand your application. And then you annotate directly on your source code. This malloc, for example, here has allocated, so this is quite small, but 300 bytes or kilobytes or megabytes. So here you have new mineable units also, which is not done in KakaGrind. And some red color, for example, here on the file, I try to color in red the hotspot. So the thing which on the metric you selected are possibly an issue. And so when you click on this annotation, you can get all the details of this location, so the range of sizes it allocates, the lifetime, and all those things, and the call stack which lead to this location. So you can quickly understand from where your allocations are coming. So similarly, this is something you already have in KakaGrind. You get the call tree, so already again it's annotated with the numbers, and colored a little bit with red to get the hotspots. So this has been done by a customer student at CERN, this thing. Also, I was working for supercomputers, so now in supercomputers we know we are running with multi-threaded applications. So I wanted also to export how the things are balanced. So which thread is making all the allocation, or is it balanced over the threads? Do I have a thread which is making all the free, or this kind of stuff? So you can get a quick view on what happened on your application on this side. So the way you stress the memory allocator under hood. You can get also the time view. So for example, there is a lot of charts like this in the tool. So I just extracted some of them. But you can get, for example, when you speak about memory consumption, people in the operating system know there is three numbers which are interesting. So the physical memory of your application, so the real memory you are consuming, the virtual one, because there can be a gap between the two, and the requested one, which is the one you allocated with malloc. And in some cases, if you can go and look, for example, in this case, this is a real application which was developed in my university. At some point, the guy was freeing all the application with using free, but the physical memory of the application was staying. So there was a kind of fragmentation which was there, and the tool directly pointed it. So also you can look this kind of stuff. So for example, the size, the chunk sizes you are allocating over the time. So for example, you can see if you are always allocating blocks of 1 byte, for example, all over the application life, or the size you have. Or the lifetime, depending on the size. So for example, we know that if you are allocating, 10 megabytes for 1 microsecond, you know for sure that your operating system will start to have some performance issues. So you can quickly detect this kind of thing just looking at the charts. And this is something I was seeing a lot during my PhD implementing my memory allocator. So here, just an example. So this was, a numerical simulation which was developed by a company. And when we started to profile the application, and there is also what I call the allocation rate. So if you allocate too much memory and freeing it, allocating and this kind of thing, you can have what we can call an allocation rate which is too heavy. And so the operating system, mostly Linux, will start to slow down your application due to this. And here, this is something you have. You allocate 6 gigabytes per second during the initial phase of this application with these peaks and something going down. So we started to look on, then when you see this kind of pattern, you can look then on the source code to try to understand. And you can find with the metric, you can get which function is allocating all this memory. So there is what I call the cumulated allocation. So I sum up all the malloc done on this line. So here there is 57 gigabytes allocated by this line. So this is mostly all the stuff. You click and you can get all the details here and see, for example, that you're allocating chunks from 16 kilobytes to 33 megabytes. So clearly, this is a realloc pattern. You're allocating, freeing a segment, allocating a new one just a little bit bigger, and looping like this. So if you look the rest of the code, this is inside the loop, and you are looping like this. And of course, in Fortran, this is a Fortran application. In Fortran, you don't have realloc, so you do it by hand, and you make this kind of stupid thing. So we made some patches to do it less frequently, and we were able to gain a factor 2 in the performance of the initialization phase of this application, just by looking quickly in the tool in 10 minutes. So for the usage, I was a little bit fast. So for the usage, the thing is quite easy. You just need to recompile your application with the compile flag enabled. You can also run without, but if you don't have the compile flag, the debug flag, I cannot provide you the source annotation, so knowing on which line you are making your allocations. So you have all the rest of the tool, but you lose this thing. So just recompile your application with -g, or the thing if you are using another compiler. Then to run, this is just like Valgrind. You do malt your program and the options of your program. You can also provide a config file to tune a little bit the profiler if you want to check some things, and then run, and you obtain your JSON file as an output. And then you can start the graphical interface, which is a small web server. So it's implemented currently in Node.js, so JavaScript, and providing the JSON file you obtain, and you just connect on your browser. And notice it's also an interesting thing using this kind of technology in high performance computing, because most of the time when you run on a supercomputer, you are running remotely. You are on your laptop, you connect on the supercomputer, running there remotely. And then most of the time, at some point, you need to X-forward the tool you are using to profile your application, which, depending on your connection, can slow down a lot the thing. Splitting the two with a server and your nice local rendering in your Firefox on your laptop, and just making a port forwarding via SSH, you can get fluid rendering locally without getting any issues. So that's also an interesting point working like this. So anyway, if you don't want to just launch by yourself your browser, there is a Qt wrapper which embedded Node.js and WebKit in the same thing. So just to get something, you just launch like a cache grind and get the view without doing anything. So ideally, I would like to also make the thing with Electron, which is maybe better to do this thing. This is just I didn't have time and it was quicker to make this like this first, but at some point, maybe I should do it. So the tool is now open source since roughly 1 year on this website. If you're interested, I will also present this NumaProf tool, which is really similar, but for the non-uniform memory accesses, which is something more common in HPC. This is roughly the same backend for the tool. I will present it in the HPC track tomorrow if you're interested. So if you're also interested for memory management issues, mostly for HPC, you can go on my website. I put all my research on it, so you can find some materials if you want. About Malt also, it has been validated on some applications, and I myself use it a lot during my development at CERN, and we also used it on a really big code, which was 2 million lines of code, C++ code. So at least the tool is working. I mean, it's not perfect. Of course, there's still a lot of things to improve, but I mean, it's quite well, I think. So thanks, if you have any questions.
Okay, so we have a few minutes for questions. So who would like to ask a question?
Can you give a very rough estimate as to how much it slows down your program?
It roughly depends on how heavily you make some allocations, because I'm making a backtrace on every malloc. So of course, if you're making millions of allocations, at some point, the overhead can be, the lower I think is something like 20x something. But if your application is just making some allocation, it can be zero also, I mean, close to zero. So I have also a second backup mode. So you know, if you enable in your compiler, you have an option which is, I forget the name. There is an option to put some hooks when you enter and exit functions. And from this, I can rebuild the stack without calling backtrace. So if you're making millions of allocations, this is faster. So you can backup in this mode and then lower down the overhead, still having a big one. But you lose some view because, for example, you will not see anymore what happened in the library you didn't recompile.